Hello, welcome to Dell EMC Networking Solutions Engineering. In this video, we'll be taking a look at deploying a Layer 2 LeafSpine architecture with Dell EMC XC series. Hyper-coverged infrastructure, or HCI, is a software-defined architecture with integrated compute, software-defined storage, networking, and virtualization. It decouples compute, storage, and networking from underlying infrastructure. Dell EMC XC series hyper-converged appliances integrate Dell EMC powered servers, Nutanix software, and a choice of factory-installed hypervisors. With flexible combinations of CPU, memory, SSD or HDD, and global support by Dell EMC, they are ideal for enterprise business applications, server virtualizations, hybrid or private cloud projects, and virtual desktop infrastructure. XC series has a fault-tolerant architecture and self-healing capabilities, leading to system reliability and data integrity. The traditional networking three-layer tree consists of access, aggregation, and core layers. A major issue in data centers include increasing east-to-west traffic and scaling effectively as the business grows. East-to-west traffic is the traffic within the data center. LOS, or LeafSpine network, is becoming widely adopted as it is designed to minimize number of hops between the hosts. Every leaf switch is connected to every spine switch. All leaf switches are just one hop away from each other. This minimizes latency and bottlenecks in the network. The LeafSpine architecture is highly scalable. As we add more racks to the data center, a pair of leaf switches are added to each rack. Spine switches are added as bandwidth need increases. Each rack has a pair of leaf switches. They are in VLT. Every leaf switch is connected to every spine switch. In rack 1, leaf 1 is connected to spine 1 and 2. Leaf 2 is connected to spine 1 and 2. Similarly, in rack 2, leaf 3 is connected to spine 1 and 2. Leaf 4 is connected to spine 1 and 2. The connections between leaf and spine switches can be layer 3 or routed, or they can be layer 2 or switched. In this video, we'll be looking at layer 2 architecture. The leaf pair in each rack and the spine switches are in VLT. VLT provides higher availability, eliminates spanning tree block ports, provides layer 2 multipathing, and load balances traffic. In a layer 3 architecture, the traffic between the leaf and spine is routed. That is, L3, L2 boundary is at leaf switches. The spine switches are never connected to each other. ECMP is used to load balance traffic across layer 3 network. Leaf switches in each rack are in VLT. Connections within the racks from host to leaf switches are layer 2. There are a few considerations while choosing the type of LeafSpine architecture that you want to implement in the data center. Layer 2 or switched architecture puts everything in a single broadcast domain. Since layer 3 architecture involves routing, it breaks up broadcast domain. The spine switches are on VLT and hence limited to two switches at the spine layer. Layer 3 topology allows the addition of spine switches as the bandwidth need grows, and hence layer 3 is much more scalable. Overlay networks utilizing VXLANs such as VMware NSX require a layer 3 underlay network. Ultimately, choosing layer 2 or layer 3 is a matter of preference, and it requires careful consideration of advantages and disadvantages of each architecture type. The protocols used in layer 2 architecture are Rapid Spanning Tree Protocol, RSTP, Link Aggregation Control Protocol, LACP, Uplink Failure Detection, UFD, Virtual Link Trunking, VLT. RSTP is used as a precaution to prevent loops. VLT environments by nature are loop-free, but using spanning tree as a precautionary measure is considered best practice. LACP is used to aggregate ports into a LAC. Port channels are created between leaf and spines. UFD automatically detects the loss of upstream connectivity and shuts down downstream ports. VLT allows physical link between two switches to appear as a single virtual link to other switches. For more information, please refer to your switch user guide. Let's take a look at the topology used in this layer 2 leaf spine example. S4048ON are used as leaf switches and S6010ON are used as spine switches. The leaf pairs in rack 1 and 2 are in VLT. Spine 1 and 2 are in VLT as well. Port channels 101, 102 and 103 connects to node 1, 2 and 3 of the XC cluster. Port channel 1 from leaf 1 and 2 VLT pair connects to spine 1 and 2 VLT pair. Similarly, port channel 2 from leaf 3 and 4 VLT pair connects to spine 1 and 2 VLT pair. Leaf 3 and 4 switches connects to our R630 server using port channel 101. VLAN is configured across the switches. We are using VLAN 10 in this example. A virtual machine is created on one of the XC cluster node. All the nodes in this XC appliance run VMware ESXi. In order to follow the configuration easily, the topology diagram will be displayed often while looking at the switch CLI. The initial switch configuration involves setting the hostname, enabling LLDP, enabling RSTP, setting the management IP address, and the default route. These initial configurations are implemented across all the switches used in this example. The next step is to configure VLT. Ports 49 and 50 are used as VLTI interconnect. Bring these ports up by issuing a no-shut command. Configure port channel 127 for VLTA and add the members ports 49 and 50. The next step is to create VLTA domain. Add the peer link port channel, port channel 127. Provide the backup destination as management IP address of leaf 2 and provide unit ID as 0. Ports TE1/1 to TE1/3 connects to XC nodes. Issue the no-shut command on these ports. The ports TE1/1 to TE1/3 on leaf 2 are initially kept shut down until teaming and failover is configured on vSphere web client. Add ports FO1/51 and FO1/53 into port channel 1 using LACP. Issue the no-shut command on these ports. The next step is to configure the port channels. Configure port channel 1. Use switch port command to make it into layer 2 and enable port mode hybrid. For port channels 101, 102 and 103, in addition, issue the spanning tree RSTP HPort command since they are connecting to the XE appliance. It is very important to issue the VLT peer lag port channel command to ensure that the port channels operate as expected. The next step is to configure VLAN. Then the final step is to configure UFT. If uplinks to the spine fails, then ports to servers will be shut down. Let's take a look at Leaf 3 in Rack 2. After performing the initial basic configurations, no-shut port TE1/48. TE1/48 connects to a R630 server. Issue the no-shut command on the VLTA interconnect ports. Configure interfaces FO1/51 and FO1/53 as a port channel and add it into port channel 2 using LACP. Issue the no-shut command on these ports. The next step is to configure port channel 2 and port channel 101. Port channel 127 is used for VLTA port channel. Configure VLAN 10 and tag port channel 2 and untag port channel 101. VLAN 10 is configured and used in all switches. Then the final step is to configure UFT. If uplinks to the spine fails, then the port to the server R630 will be shut down. Let's look at spine 1 configuration. After finishing the initial configuration, such as hostname, LLDP, enabling RSTP, configure the interfaces that are used for port channel 1. Do note that spine 1 will be forced to act as a root bridge in RSTP by setting the bridge priority to 0. Configure the interfaces that are used for port channel 1. Interfaces FO1/25 and FO1/26 are added into port channel 1, while interfaces FO1/27 and 1/28 are added into port channel 2. The interfaces are added into port channel using LACP. Issue the no-shut command on these ports. Ports 31 and 32 are used as VLTA interconnects. Port channel 127 is used for VLTA port channel. The next step is to create VLTA domain. The next step is to configure port channel 1 and 2. Use switch port, port mode hybrid. Most importantly, issue the VLT peer like port channel command. The final step is to configure VLAN 10 on this switch. Similarly on Spine 2, configure interfaces 25 and 26 into port channel 1 and interfaces 27 and 28 into port channel 2. Issue the no-shut command on the VLTE interconnect ports FO1/31 and FO1/32. Configure port channels 1 and 2. Port channel 127 is used as VLTA port channel. Finally, configure VLAN 10. Validating the LeafSpine setup involves commands that verify the configurations. For VLT, use show VLT brief. ICL link status, heartbeat status, and VLT peer status should all be up. Use show VLT mismatch to identify any VLT issues. Use show spanning tree RSTP brief to view the RSTP details. To verify port channels created using LACP, use show LACP summary. To dig deeper into the port channel, issue show LACP followed by the port channel number. Let's look at Leaf 3 to display the VLAN information. Show VLAN displays the VLANs configured on the switch. Note that VLAN 10 and its associated ports are displayed. On Spine 1, verify the VLT configuration. Use show spanning tree RSTP brief to view the RSTP details. Note that spanning tree RSTP displays Spine 1 as a root. This is because Spine 1 was forced to act as a root by setting the bridge priority as 0. To verify port channels created using LACP, use show LACP summary. To dig deeper into the port channel, issue show LACP followed by the port channel number. Ensure that similar commands are run across all switches in this example to verify the configurations. Refer to your switch user guide to look into various other commands that can be used to validate the configurations. The final validation is to perform a ping test between the virtual machines in XC node and the R630 server. The nodes in the XC cluster run VMware ESXi. Windows Server 2016 is the name of the virtual machine that was created. In this example, IP address 172.16.1.6 is set on the R630 server. IP address 172.16.1.7 is set on the virtual machine on the XE node. Ping 172.16.1.6 from the virtual machine and 172.16.1.7 from R630. In this video, we looked at deploying Layer 2 LeafSpine architecture along with the XE appliance. Thanks for watching this video. For additional information on deploying Layer 2 LeafSpine architecture and deploying XE series, click on the links in the description. For more networking solutions, visit the Dell Networking Tech Center. Lastly, do not forget to check out the Layer 3 LeafSpine video.